said you listen to Santa Claus? Yeah? Who wants to work for the railroad? Not me either. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, what's next?
Make it snow again. Blow the whistle.
Make it blow and snow the whistle. You got it.
Excuse me.
Pardon me, ma'am.
No, I really don't have time.
Ma'am, this young man was here first.
But I want to buy one.
Well, I have no reason to believe that my young friend here doesn't want to buy one.
Blow the whistle. Blow it again.
Yeah!
Blow it again.
Yeah!
Yeah!
Excuse me, sir, but it appears the lady has friends in high places. Do you know much about this train?
I don't need to know it. Look, the train is perfect and I'm in a terrible hurry. Anything else I need to know about it, I can look up in the manual. Here's my card.
Fairmay Advertising.
Yes.
Well, that will be $1,298 plus tax. And we offer free gift wrapping, free...
No, thank you. I don't have time.
Well, we'd be happy to deliver it to your client.
No, it's not for a client. It's for my son.
Huh?
A bag will be fine.
All sales are final.
Has he fired me yet? Have you got the train? Over here.
Yeah, I can't set the plates till the train is on set.
No.
Where did you finally find one?
Oh, I had to buy it. $1,400.
$14?
Yes. I just put it on the cart.
Jerry will kill you. Then he'll fire you.
No, he won't even know. I'm going to return it first thing in the morning.
There you are. You're fired.
I'll take the train with me.
Get back in here with that.
What are we pushing it to ask for a raise?
Why don't you step?
Glad to see you.
Hi.
Hi, Mary.
You look like you've had a day. Dinner's all right. It just has to be heated up.
Thank you.
We'll see you tomorrow. Good night. Night to me.
Night, Mary.
Hey, Tim. Would you put the groceries in the kitchen for me, please?
Stuff in the refrigerator.
Oh, thank you, honey. So, Mr. Annis, what did you do today?
Play with Joey in the park.
Oh, yeah? What'd you play?
Snowballs.
Snowballs?
You throw snowballs at girls and they chase you.
Yeah, I used to play that, too. The other way around.
Oh, my feet.
You're too tired, huh, Mom?
Oh, I'm not too tired, honey. I'm a little tired. I'll perk up here in a few minutes. Oh, that feels really good.
There, all better now.
How are those teeth coming? Ah, very good. You're looking more and more like your father every day.
Mom? Does it hurt very much to die?
I don't think so, sweetheart. Come on, we gotta get a move on. Paul's coming to dinner and we've got a lot to do.
I can help you, Mom.
Oh, thanks, sweetie. They're pretty heavy.
They for me?
One of them might be.
The big one?
No, honey. That's from the shoot today. I have to return it tomorrow.
Well, why does it have a bow on it?
You buy a garbage can at Christmas, they put a bow on it. All right, I gotta get things going in the kitchen. Will you wash your hands for me? Come on, you can do it. I know you can, and I'm sure that you need it. Let me see.
Ugh. I don't. Oh, I washed my hands this morning.
You need to wash them again.
No, I don't.
Your food will taste better.
No, it won't. It'll taste soapier.
Then rinse them. In here.
Just washing my face, Mom.
Well, everything seems okay. Just remember our deal, though. The closet's off limits, right?
Right.
What are you giggling about, you little demon?
I'm not.
We're gonna have a nice Christmas. We always do. Just don't wish for the moon, okay? Maybe a couple stars.
My teacher says we shouldn't be afraid to wish for things, even stuff we think might never come true in a million zillion years.
Yeah, well, she should try paying my bills. All right, I can't leave in the morning without that. And please pick up your toys, or at least clear a path. And sweetie, leave that alone, okay? I really have to return it in the morning.
Dishes done?
Saved them all for you. Hey, get back here. Teach you to stand me up. Thank you. Have you eaten?
Yeah, take that. I'm really sorry.
It's all right. Did you finish it at least?
Yes, and it is brilliant. A brilliant brief, if I say so myself.
And who better to say it?
Hello, Tim.
Hi.
Hey, tomorrow's tree day. Can you get off?
No, I have to work. You boys get all the fun.
We might even take in a movie. I've got the whole afternoon free.
Wow.
What do you say, Tim?
Maybe.
Hey, Tim. If you can talk Paul into a video game, he doesn't have to do the dishes tonight.
Yes!
Well, I am sort of tired tonight. I don't really feel much like playing.
Are you okay?
Yeah, I think I just might go to my room.
But that's probably a good idea. You've got a really big day tomorrow. Why don't you brush your teeth, feed your turtles? I'll come tuck you in. Timmy, say goodnight to Paul.
Night, Paul.
See you tomorrow, Tim.
Hope he's not getting sick.
Well, he's a great kid. I'm always talking about him at the office. And about his great mom.
Flattery will get you everywhere. Come on. I'll do the dishes. You can watch.
You look tired tonight.
I swear, if one more person tells me I look tired, I must really look terrible.
Oh, you look beautiful, as always, but tired.
Yeah, it's a crazy day today. Heads up.
Hey, we're getting pretty good at this.
Yeah, pretty good team.
Marry me, I'll buy you a dishwasher.
Dishwasher, trash compactor, sub-zero refrigerator. I'm holding out for the works.
You know how I feel about you, Jody. Yeah, I haven't wanted to crowd you, but... you know, I've had a great year, and I've decided it's time to buy a house, and I'd like it to be our house. I'm asking you to marry me, Jody. Uh-oh.
No, I just wasn't expecting anything like this tonight.
Look, I know how you felt about Jeff. I'm not trying to take his place, but I'm crazy about you, Jody.
Oh, Paul, I care for you so much, and you're just the most wonderful. I just need some time. Can we wait until after the holidays? Because it's not just about me, it's about Timmy as well. I would love to be able to tell you now.
No, I want you to be sure. The holidays it is.
Okay.
Hey, you're falling behind there. Does it feel like yes?
Paul, you're terrible.
Oh, excuse me. Could you help me, please?
One minute, please. These kids are driving me nuts.
Excuse me. Oh, excuse me.
Okay, banana bread. Show's over. Hey, you.
Hey, let me guess. You hooked it up, plugged it in, and it didn't work.
What?
The train. You've come to return it, right? I knew you would.
Oh, you did?
Yeah, just before you left yesterday, I said to myself, that very attractive young lady is not going to keep that train. She'll be back, and here you are.
Well, I didn't know at the time.
I figure you or your company used it for something, maybe transporting hors d'oeuvres.
No, that is not what happened.
It's just that, you know what? I could have sold that train 5 times over to someone who really wanted it.
I know, and I really do feel badly about it, but this train will sell in no time, and so if you could just take care of the refund, I'll disappear and never darken your doorstep again.
Well, I'm not sure I'd like that, but... Okay, what do you want?
Store credit or exchange?
I'd like it taken off my credit card.
Oh, I'm sorry. Store policy.
But that's a $1,400 train. My boss will fire me. I can't believe this is happening. It's Christmas time. I've got a son to support.
Bet your husband needs an operation, too, right?
My husband is dead. He was killed in the Hudson Street fire.
I'm sorry. Now I feel like a complete jerk.
No, I'm sorry, too. I know you didn't mean anything by it. Look, this is just really serious for me at work. And I know I shouldn't have borrowed the train, but, you know, sometimes you just get in a panic and you do what you gotta do. And I'll understand if you absolutely can't help me.
I'm gonna regret this, but follow me and act casual.
Thank you so much.
Credit card? Excuse me.
Right here. I can't tell you how much I appreciate this.
I'll mention it. Next time you want to train, try Amtrak.
Okay. It's a deal. Thank you. Oh, don't want to forget this. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
You know company policy, you're fired.
That's what I've been trying to tell you.
Darling, you remember?
Ah, now, let me see. For your husband here, I'd have to say he's a 42 or a 44.
No, he's not my... I would like the special size, the 56.
I like things loose and airy.
I'll have to check the stockroom.
Thank you.
For someone you know?
No, it's for a photo shoot. I promise I won't try to return it. You're not following me around to see if I'm going to return it.
Nah. I mean, I could if you'd like me to. I do have the spare time. I was just fired.
Fired? Why? No, me? Oh, I feel terrible.
Yeah, me too.
Is there anything I can do?
Well, now that you mention it, yeah, there is. You could buy me lunch. I mean, since I am no longer gainfully employed, and it is that time of day.
Well, I guess I do owe you that.
I'd say you do. I pick the place and I do the ordering.
We're not talking the Ritz here, are we?
See that duck? He's the happiest guy in this town, and he'll never be CEO of anything.
On this rate, neither will you.
Oh. Point is, neither one of us is trying to be anything other than what we are.
Which is?
A couple of ducks.
So what other jobs have you done?
Well, it was a taxi driver, a waiter, a truck driver.
Oh, a man of many talents.
A survivor, anyway.
Me too, survivor.
Somehow it sounded better when I said it, like I was maybe having more fun surviving.
Driving a taxi was fun.
It was better than being a stockbroker, for me, anyway.
You were a stockbroker?
Yeah, straight out of business school till 6 months ago.
What happened?
I quit.
Why?
I didn't like it anymore. I was successful, so it took me a while to realize that, but one morning I walked into the office, and it was like I'd walk into a brick wall. Bam. Just hard enough to wake me up. I turned around and I walked out. And I never looked back.
You didn't. You just quit?
I decided there had to be more to life than that.
Oh, I wish I could just walk out.
Well, your problem is you don't believe.
In what?
Possibilities. The future. Happy endings. Santa Claus.
I believe in Santa Claus.
What is it that you really want to do?
Career? Well, if I could ever finish my degree, I'd like to teach kindergarten. I think you're probably the only living soul that knows that.
I'm honored that you told me.
Like a sculptor works in clay, I work in wood.
Ah, the artiste.
Well, that's for someone else to decide. I just like you doing it. I redid my apartment.
Really?
I could show you. I live right over there. Hey, that wasn't a line. It's just that my lease is up at the end of the month.
Your lease? You're losing your apartment, too? It's been quite a month for you. Unemployed, homeless.
Jump to conclusions. I'm a survivor, remember?
Yeah. Well, I have to go. I got to get back to the office. Steve, thank you so much for your help today. I can take this now.
I'm not going to abandon you now.
Oh, really?
No.
Well, I could use the extra pair of arms.
I'm throwing the legs for free.
You sure you can carry all that?
Page 4. Thank you, sir. Happy holidays, Merry Christmas.
This is bringing back a lot of bad memories, you know? I wanted to be the angel in our third grade Christmas
but
play.
But they made you the dog.
Yeah. Just naturally a beast of burden, I guess.
You volunteered.
That's what my third grade teacher said, too.
Yes, sir. Transfer to Red Line at 26th Street Station.
Very good.
Passengers on C train.
Steve, I'm
trained. To Red Line at 26th
Street Station. Tony! Tony!
Do you hold these?
Yes, dear.
Before you got home, didn't we, Tim?
Mom, I picked it out.
Started out a little slow today, but after a double hot fudge sundae, he found the strength.
Well, it is absolutely the most beautiful Christmas tree I've ever seen. Did the agency call?
No. Anything wrong?
No, I just misplaced some packages.
Well, where do you think you left them? I could,
It's not necessary. There's really no way to know where they are. I'm sure someone will just return them to the agency.
But if they find them, how will they know to...
Hi, Jody. It's Kimberly. Call me
the receipt. Mr. Ennis, you are the greatest picker-outer. Have you got a kiss for me?
He hasn't. I have.
Sorry, it's already spoken for. Oh! Gotcha anyway.
We're taking you out to dinner, too.
You are? After today, that's exactly what I need. You're a very nice man.
Hey, do that again. See what you do to me?
Hey, Tim. Could you go find your new gray sweater and put it on since we're going out?
You didn't like me kissing you.
I told him that you asked me to marry you.
Aha. So that's why he ran so hot and cold with me today. He's not happy about it.
He's not unhappy. Children just don't like change. It scares them. I remember when I was about 4, we moved, and my mother was so busy throwing out junk, I was convinced that she would throw me out, too.
I'm glad she didn't.
Thank you. And Tim likes you a lot, so...
I have one request.
Sure.
When we take down the lights this year, let's not tie them in knots. Okay?
I don't intentionally tie them in knots. The box does.
Ho, ho, ho! Merry Christmas. Well, you didn't lose me on purpose, did you?
No.
Good. But this is the last time I pick up a girl at Christmas. You know, I spent the last 2 hours stuck... Hello.
How do you do?
Paul, this is Steve.
Mason.
Mason. And this is Paul.
Davis. Paul Davis. Pleasure to meet you, Paul.
These are the missing packages.
Yes, yes, the very ones. Thank you so much. I'm so glad you found them.
You found the packages.
No, I had the packages. It was her I lost.
He didn't lose me. See, we met at Crowley's this morning.
She got me fired.
That's how we met. And so then after lunch...
Lunch?
Mr. Mason was kind enough to carry the package down to the subway.
That's how we got separated.
In the crowd.
It happens in crowds. After lunch.
How did you ever find me?
Your agency. Jody, this is a wonderful place. Yeah, I bet there's mahogany under this paint. They used a lot of mahogany in these old buildings. It looked beautiful, restored.
Why don't I get Mr. Mason something to drink? Sweetheart?
You know, I wouldn't say no.
I'll get us all something to drink. Some eggnog.
Looks as if it'll be a white Christmas after all.
Yeah, yeah. Never seems like Christmas unless it is white.
Right. Weather's been pretty strange these days.
Yeah.
Global warming.
Global warming.
Right.
You need a hand with this?
No, I'm pretty good at untangling things. I'm an attorney.
Oh.
It's okay, everything's fine, not to worry.
Why don't you take your coat off?
Forgot I had it on.
Mm-hmm.
Was this her husband? Did you know him?
Jeff? No. Sometimes I feel like I knew him. He died a hero, you know?
Yeah.
A young doctor walking home at night. This fire saved three people. But he didn't make it.
Hard.
But she's come a long way.
Here we are.
Let me help you pet, sweetheart.
Thank you. I thought wine would be more festive.
Here you go, Steve.
Thank you.
Huh? Thank you.
Well.
Well. Here's to a merry
Christmas.
Mom, there's a big mess in the kitchen.
Oh, honey, it's okay. Don't worry about it. Steve, I would like you to meet the man of the house. This is Mr. Ennis.
Hello, Tim. It's a pleasure to meet you. I've heard some very nice things about you.
You have?
Yes, I have. My name is Steve. Steve Mason.
Hello, Mr. Mason.
It's a really nice tree you got there. You know what kind that is?
Christmas tree.
The very best kind.
Of course, I picked it out.
Hey, we made a pretty good team, didn't we?
Well, I saw it first.
Well, you got a good eye. That's a nice tree. Not too many people have an eye like you. What are you going to get for Christmas this year besides clothes?
I always get clothes.
That's not all you're getting.
You'll never guess what I'm getting you.
A camera.
How'd you know that?
You asked me if I wanted one.
Timmy.
Oh.
That doesn't sound very nice.
Well, Jody, he didn't mean it the way he sounded, did you, big guy? But you know, Tim, if everything works out the way I hope it will, I'll be getting you a lot of things next Christmas.
I don't want you to.
Tim?
I don't want him to get me anything.
Timothy Ennis, if you can't be polite, go to your room.
No.
Tim.
Why?
Do what your mother says.
I'll have to when you can't make me.
Now, Timothy. Wait a minute, son.
I'm not your son, you keep your camera!
All
Timothy!
Right, man. Let's go.
No, I don't have to.
You need a little assistance.
Stop it! Let go of me!
Paul!
You keep your hands off my mother, too!
Paul, put down my son!
Goodbye, Jody.
Paul, I'm sorry.
I'll call you tomorrow.
Bed with you right now. What is the matter with you?
I wasn't sure if I should go or...
Oh, no, it's fine to stay. It's fine. I'm sorry about before. He's really not like that at all.
Who, Paul?
Him either.
Is he okay?
Yeah. Yeah, he's fine now.
You didn't tell Paul about me, did you?
No.
Why not?
What? I didn't think it was important.
Paul seemed to think it was.
I don't tell Paul everything. My life is my life.
Should go before things get more complicated. Goodbye, Jody.
Well, that sounds like goodbye, goodbye.
It is. I started to tell you in the park today, I'm leaving the city.
You are?
Yeah, an old college buddy of mine, an architect, called me about a month ago. We pooled our resources, we're going into business together. In Virginia.
Oh, Virginia.
Yeah, we already got our first job. We're converting this 100-year-old barn into a restaurant brewery.
Oh, that's great. When do you leave?
New Year's Eve, on the midnight train.
Well, you certainly are romantic. Out with the old, in with the new.
Except you're new.
Oh, after New Year's Eve, I won't be. I'll be last year's funny story, and you'll be...
Forgotten? Anyways, probably for the best, my leaving. For both of us, you know. If I stayed, I'd probably fall in love with you.
You would?
Yeah. Then I'd ask you to marry me.
You would?
You'd say no.
Oh, I would. Why?
I don't know, Jody.
What do I know?
Just doesn't seem like you want any changes in your life.
I never said I didn't want change.
No, but I mean, you got all these pictures of your husband around here. You call Timmy Mr. Ennis. You live in the same apartment.
Who are you to judge me?
You're right. I'm sorry.
You don't know me. You don't know me at all. For your information, I'm marrying Paul.
Well, that's a good safe bet.
Yes, it is.
Okay, Jody. I'm on my way.
You mind if I say goodbye to Tim?
Of course not.
I wonder what happened to that girl in the picture. I mean, she looks like she's ready for anything.
She thought so. It's a long time ago.
That's funny. I thought I was with her in the park today.
Mom, can I have some juice?
How about bread and water?
Hello.
Hi, Tim. How are you? Doing okay?
Yeah. I don't know why I got so mad.
Well, hey, it happens sometimes, you know? Next time you see Paul, you just tell him you're sorry. He'll understand.
Those are my turtles, Thunder and Lightning. They live out here because I used to let them swim in the bathtub.
What, something happened to them?
Lightning almost went down the drain once, but I saved him.
Whoa. You ought to get them a hyacinth blossom. They like to nibble on them.
Cool.
Tim, I was just coming to say so long. Take good care of your mom. She's a real neat lady, right? It was real nice to meet you.
Did my mom really get you fired?
How'd you know that?
I heard you talking. I didn't close my door.
You ever try using a glass on the door when it's closed?
Yeah. Doesn't work.
Doesn't.
But how did my mom get you fired?
Well, I sold your mom a train. And then when she brought it back, I did something I wasn't supposed to do.
A train? Ran silver with the whistle and fork?
Yeah. You saw it?
Yeah. But don't tell my mom.
Oh, I won't. Why?
I peeked. I thought it was for me, but it wasn't. Sure was a cool train.
Yeah, it was a cool train, wasn't it? You don't give up hope, okay?
I don't even let myself think about it anymore. Because I know I can't have it. You should only wish for things that you can get, or you'll be disappointed.
Well, if you don't have your dreams, how can they come true?
I wished and wished for a train until my stomach hurt. Mom took it back anyway.
You know, Tim, Christmas is a pretty magical time, so don't give up hope, okay? You should never know.
Tim, time for bed.
Hey, why don't I walk you back to your dungeon?
Okay.
Okay.
You come back again?
No, I'm afraid I can't. But I'll see if I can't rustle you up some supper before I go.
Don't worry. Even when I'm bad, Mom gives me supper.
Well, it was nice to meet you, Timmy. You have a Merry Christmas, okay?
Hello?
Paul, I thought I would get your machine.
Would you rather talk to my machine?
No.
Good. Jody, I'm very sorry about it.
I know you are. Look, I know that you would never hurt Timmy, and I'm very sorry that I talked to you like that. Paul, why don't you come back over? We can spend some time.
Jody, are you still there?
Yes, I'm still here. Paul, will you marry me?
Paul? Paul?
Yes, I'm still, Do you mean it?
Yes, of course I mean it. Does the offer still stand?
Are you kidding? Oh, Jody. We should do it as soon as we can. New Year's Day. Jody? Jody?
Okay. New Year's Day.
You've made me very, very happy.
I opened the front door to get the paper, and there it was.
There what was?
Well, Mom, I love it. I wish that I'd listened. See? These two go together, and the car's light up.
Yes, it's a wonderful train.
And these doors open and close.
Timmy, this whistled at me when I passed and said it wanted you for Christmas. Santa. Well, I guess it's from Santa Claus.
Oh, Mom, Santa Claus. Come on. I have a surprise for you, too. Look, I wrapped it myself. It's perfume.
Perfume? I need perfume. Let's see. Oh, Tim, I love it. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna kiss for that one.
I fooled you. You fooled me, and I fooled you.
You sure did.
But how'd you know I wanted to train? I didn't tell anybody. I only told Mr. Mason.
Mr. Mason?
He said he wouldn't tell you I peeked at it.
Well, he didn't tell me any. You peeked at what? The one I brought home.
I thought it was for me.
And then I said it wasn't, didn't I?
And I cried.
Oh, Tim, I've got to tell you about this train. Hello?
Merry Christmas, love.
Hi, Paul. Hold on one second. Tim, I'll be right back. Why don't you pick up some clothes? Grandma and Gramps are going to be here soon.
Did I wake you? You sound a little...
I am a little.
A little ticked off is what I am. But you remember that guy from the other night, Steve Mason?
Oh.
I think he got Tim this, like, $1,000 train.
What? Why?
I have no idea why. They met maybe once.
Well, it's pretty obvious, isn't it?
Paul, I promise you, you have nothing to worry about. It's not my type. Not his either.
Well, send it back.
Timmy loves it. I can't take it away from him, but I can't accept it either. It's too much. This guy doesn't have that kind of money.
Let's give the money back. I'd be glad to do that, darling.
Paul, I appreciate it, but I can't let you do that. Now, look, I got myself into this. I'll get myself out.
Okay.
I gotta get back to Timmy.
I'll see you later.
Merry Christmas, sweetheart.
Don't be late later, okay?
Merry Christmas.
Bye.
Bye, darling.
What are you doing?
I'm setting the table so you won't have to.
Thank you.
I'm gonna take lots better care of my stuff, and I'm gonna wash more.
Tim. I didn't give you the train.
What?
Still hope you wash more. But it's not from me.
From Santa Claus?
From Mr. Mason.
Mr. Mason? Boy, he must be rich.
No, he's not. I don't think he has very much money right now at all. I think he probably liked you a lot and wanted you to have it.
Can I give him a present, Mom?
Oh, honey, I don't think that's necessary.
But I want to. It's the best present anybody ever gave me.
Honey, I don't even know where to find him.
Did you look it up in the phone book?
Oh, Tim, I don't know.
Please.
Well, I guess there are a few things I could say to Mr. Mason myself.
What can I give him? What can I give him?
Sweetie, all the stores are closed today. Why don't you draw him a picture? He would love that.
I got a better idea.
Mason.
There it is.
Timothy, you know I bought this for Paul.
Well, I can't think this is just a coincidence.
I went to your apartment.
I'm not there.
I need to talk to you.
Breakfast?
No, thanks. I already ate. Why did you give Timmy the train?
I wanted to.
Steve, it's too expensive. I know that money's not that important to you, but I want to pay you back. I can give you some today and then
the
send you the rest next
week. The train is strictly a personal matter between my friend
no,
and me.
Steve,
no.
You never said anything about wanting a train.
Well, you said something to me.
Is that why you did it?
He's a great kid. It's Christmas. You shouldn't be afraid of wanting too much.
He sent you a present, too.
I don't know what to say.
Thanks.
Thanks.
Welcome.
Well, let's see what it is. Great. This is a great vest. Wow.
Yeah, the color's really good for you.
Yeah.
Kind of clashes with the scarf.
Well, we can't have that. Hey, friend. Want a scarf?
Thanks. Man, can I always use a little something extra?
Merry Christmas.
Steve, I didn't mean you were supposed to give it away.
It's only stuff.
You know, you put me in sort of an awkward position with Paul.
Ah.
About the train, he suspects your motives.
Well, I would, too, if I were in his shoes.
Well, of course, I told him it had nothing to do with me.
Right. He seems like a very nice fellow.
He is. That's why I'm going to marry him. I feel safe with him. And that may sound boring to you, but it's important to me. I need to feel safe. Secure.
Do you love him?
Of course.
Then why did you come looking for me?
Hey, mister! Mister!
Yes?
Did you give a man your scarf?
I did.
Well, he said he wanted to give you a present back.
Here, let me help you.
Thanks.
Where did he go?
Don't know. He is in a hurry.
Well, thank you very much.
Kathy, look at what I got. Rollerblades.
What is it?
Hey, me too.
Well, let's find out. Salt and pepper shakers. He really didn't seem the type.
No.
You want them?
No. Well.
You want to go for a cup of coffee?
I can't. I gotta get back. I've got guests coming.
Goodbye, Jody. I wish you and Paul all the best. If you're ever in Abingdon, Virginia, you look me up, okay?
Okay. Merry Christmas.
They sure didn't go this fast when I was a boy.
Oh, Timmy. Looks like your mom's home. John?
Coming.
I'm so sorry. I had no idea it would take so long.
Hi there. Let me get that.
Oh, thank you. Hey, you've got it up and running.
Grandpa helped.
Yeah, Tim did most of it.
Oh, he's growing up too fast, Jody. And he's grown at least 2 inches.
Easily.
He looks more like Jeff every time I see him. John, you remember the way Jeff had
now, that... Susan.
Mom, look at the catcher's mitt Graham and Gramps bought me. And a baseball and a bat.
I see. Very cool grandparents. I'm so happy you're both here.
Mr. Mason like his present, Mom?
Mm-hmm.
Aha, yes, your new fella.
My new what?
We're looking forward to meeting him today. Tim says he's coming to dinner. We're very happy for you, Judy.
No, he's not my new...
We'll dance at your wedding.
No, I'm not marrying Mr. Mason. Timothy, you know perfectly well I'm not marrying Steve.
I didn't say who you were gonna marry.
But he's been talking about Mr. Mason all morning.
Look, I don't even know Mr. Mason. We just met each other. No, I'm marrying Paul.
Paul?
Well, you remember Paul.
Oh, yes, Paul. Oh, well, that's very good news, isn't it, John?
Yes, very.
Oh, yeah, Mom, I forgot. Paul called.
He did?
But I told him you went to see Mr. Mason at his apartment.
Terrific. What'd he say?
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
For dinner?
Thank you.
Hello.
Hello, Mrs.
Nice
Innes.
To see you.
Very nice to see you.
Ms. Oh, Innes? Good to see you.
Jody told us the big news.
Yes.
Congratulations.
She talked me into it.
Hey, look at the tray Mr. Mason bought me.
Let's see it back out.
Careful.
So you went to his apartment?
He wasn't there.
I didn't know you knew him so well.
I don't. I went there.
Did you ask Mr. Mason to come eat with us?
No.
He wasn't home, Tim.
He was in the park. The park?
You met him in the park.
What was he doing in the park on Christmas morning?
You're all asking me these questions about a man I hardly even know who's leaving to go build barns in Virginia anyway.
Barns?
Yes, barns. But he's going to build barns. Well, he may not build them. Well, he may. But convert them. And look, none of us are ever going to talk to him again, so why don't we just get ready to eat and enjoy the places, shall we?
Officer Johnson, ma'am. I'm looking for a Mrs. Innes.
I'm Mrs. Innes.
The Mrs. Innes that possibly might know a Steve Mason.
I know Steve Mason.
What's the matter? Did something happen to him?
I wonder if you'd mind coming down to the station with me.
Why can't you talk to her here?
Because the lieutenant's down at the station with Mr. Mason. And Mr. Mason says you'll be able to explain everything. And since it's Christmas, we thought before we put him in jail.
Jail?
Well, he says he's too broke to post bail. So, if you wouldn't mind.
Shortly before 9 this morning at a botanical garden, sir, a Mervyn Fisher was hit on the head, tied up with a man's scarf, and robbed of $356. Also stolen was a gift he was taking to his aunt on the west side, a pair of silver salt and pepper shakers. A little later, Officer Johnson, in the course of his investigation, noticed that Mr. Mason here was loitering suspiciously. He admitted he was unemployed, broke, and that the scarf belonged to him. Salt and pepper shakers were found on his person.
Oh, I'm sorry. I just thought it would be something much worse.
You expected the suspect to be involved in a serious crime?
No, no.
Jody? Lieutenant, I...
This one's a lawyer.
Is that so?
With your permission? In profound gratitude.
Did Mervyn Fisher identify Mr. Mason?
Didn't see who hit him.
Was Mr. Mason searched to see whether the stolen money was on his person?
We found $49.52 on his person.
I told them it's the only money I had.
There's nothing easier to hide than money. He stashes it, picks it up later when it's all clear.
Lieutenant.
Lieutenant, look, I can clear this up.
Well, that would make my day, miss. Because then I could get home for Christmas dinner on time, which would please my wife no end. So if Clarence Darrow there has no objections, proceed.
No, I'm interested in this myself.
Early this morning, Mr. Mason and I were in the park, and he gave his scarf away to a man that he thought was down on his luck.
Oh.
As a sort of Christmas present. And then a few minutes later, a little girl wearing rollerblades and reindeer antlers came along, gave Mr. Mason a gift from him, the salt and pepper shakers.
A little girl on rollerblades with reindeer antlers gave him the shakers?
You have to believe me.
Not if I don't want to.
Oh, there's no need to talk to her like that.
You defending her, too?
She's my fiancée.
Oh. Oh. He's your fiancée.
That's right.
Then what were you doing in the park with this guy 9 o'clock Christmas morning?
I don't see what this has to do with the case.
That's why I'm a cop and you're not.
Look, early this morning, a train arrived. An electric toy train, a very expensive one for my son from Mr. Mason.
The guy's without a job. He's broke. And he buys a kid an expensive electric train. Now, why would you do that?
Gift giving is a tradition in my family.
Yeah? And that's why you gave a complete stranger the scarf you were wearing. That a family tradition, too, huh?
No, you see, I gave Mr. Mason a vest, the one he's wearing.
What's a vest got to do with a scarf?
Exactly, they clashed.
They did, so he gave away the scarf.
You bought him a vest?
Well, no, actually, I bought it for... It was under the tree.
Ah.
The romantic relationships of the parties concerned have nothing to do with this case. Now, you have only the weakest kind of circumstantial evidence.
Then you have to believe us.
Of course I have to. It's too stupid to be made up.
No charges?
No. You can take him home. In fact, you know, you should take him home with you.
Oh, Mr. Mason.
Well, he's alone. He's broke.
I'm not broke.
You've got to have room at the table for one more, don't you?
What? Of course, if Mr.
I really don't want to intrude.
Nonsense. You wouldn't be intruding. Now, would he, Counselor?
No.
Good. Good. Now, get out of here. And, Merry Christmas.
This is my favorite Christmas ever. I want to do it again tomorrow.
Mr. Ennis.
Mommy, you look beautiful.
I agree.
Thank you. Paul, I just love the dress. Color, the style.
Well, I may pick out all your clothes from now on.
Well.
Gramps, just Gramps.
All right.
Steve!
Anyone for seconds?
No. Drumstick.
How many legs do you think a turkey has?
Well, I cooked extra. I always did for Jeff.
I always did, too.
Here, I'll get that for him. I'm gonna get another bottle anyway.
Now, that is a good idea. Yes.
Susan, would you come and finish your dinner? Don't get moody on me. Holidays, she always gets moody.
Well, you remember more on holidays.
Yes.
Little things. Funny things, like Mr. Mason's vest. Jody always bought Jeff some bright, fun things every Christmas.
Mom gave Steve that one.
Honey, you gave it to him.
Here you go.
Oh.
Look at that. Whoa! Well, you won't ask for seconds now.
I just might.
John, you've already had two.
It's all right. I need the fortitude. Because I am going to make a speech. Susan, I have been married to you 35 years. You torment me. You boss me. You tell me how to drive. You hide my things and then pretend that I've lost them, so I'll have to depend on you. You've spent 35 years trying to make me think that I couldn't get along without you. She's right.
Oh.
I couldn't. I wouldn't even want to try. Every one of those years has been good. Even the bad ones. Because you were with me. So I drink to your health and to all the wonderful years to come. Paul, just be as happy with Jody as I've been with Susan.
Thank you.
That's all.
Cheers. I just want to say that this has been the happiest Christmas of my life.
Oh.
Today I learned what I've been missing, but will never have to miss again. From now on, I'll have a family, a wife, son, and if you will share them with me, Jody, a mother and father-in-law. I've loved you for a long time, Jody, and I've waited a long time for you. But the wait was worth it. Steve, we want to thank you for having Christmas dinner with us and wish you all the luck with your new home in Virginia. I hope you find there what I have here.
Well said.
Now it's Steve's turn.
I'm too full.
Steve, you've never been one to be at a loss for words.
Well, you've all been very kind to me. You took me in, you gave me this great meal. All I really have to say is thank you very much. And Jody, Paul is a great guy. He stepped forward today. He did me a favor when he didn't have to. He's thoughtful, he's kind, and he's successful. But I think that you ought to marry me. Maybe you don't think it's right for me to speak with Timmy here, but I don't see how it can hurt him to know that two men love his mother. And maybe it's in bad taste to speak in front of Paul, but I respect him too much to go behind his back. Jody, I walked out of your life a couple of times now. Oh, okay. You walked out on me once, but I didn't stop you. And every time something has brought us back together, the packages, Timmy's train, the police, all lucky breaks for me. But I can't keep going on relying on luck. If I walk out now, I may never see you again. And despite my very best intentions, I've fallen in love with you. Will you marry
me? I think you'd better.
That's a fair answer to a fair question.
Thank you very much for your hospitality.
Money back, please.
Toy department, third floor. Hey, are you alone?
No, I got someone in the elevator.
Excuse me, honey.
Laura, it's me. Whoops.
Hey!
That was
good. Let me out! Somebody broke my train!
Ah, little boy. What have we here, huh?
I got two trains for Christmas. My mom bought me one train and my friend bought me this one. So please, can I have the money to give back to him?
This train is broken.
Just a little broke. It got broken in the elevator, but I didn't do it honest.
Where's your mother?
My mother?
Yes. You're not here all alone, are you?
No, she's here.
Where?
She's in the bathroom.
I'm sorry, but I see. I understand, but look, I'm very sorry. I'm sorry, but Mr. Crowley can't be disturbed at this time. Now, why don't you try tomorrow morning? Thank you. Well, hello. What is it, son?
Is this Mr. Crowley's office?
Why, yes, it is.
I've got to see Mr. Crowley.
Are you alone?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, what's your name?
Timothy Ennis.
Well, Mr. Timothy Ennis, what seems to be the trouble?
I got two trains for Christmas. So would Mr. Crowley give me my money back?
Well, I don't know.
He's the only one who can help me. Come on, I gotta see him.
Why don't you come with me, and let's see what we can do.
Okay.
You come sit here, Timmy. And don't you run away, all right? I think I can get Mr. Crowley to see you.
You won't call my mother or a policeman, will you?
No, I won't call your mother or a policeman, I promise.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Oh, Emily! My meditation hour.
I'm awfully sorry to disturb you, Mr. Crowley, but one of our customers, a Mr. Ennis, is outside asking to see you.
You know that I do not see the customers.
Yeah, but he's a very important customer.
Why is he so important?
Mr. Ennis is 6 years old.
6 years old?
Hmm. And he looks like he's in an awful lot of trouble.
Is he here all alone?
Oh, sir. He is the lonest little boy I've ever seen.
Well, Emily, let's not keep the customer waiting.
Yes, sir. Mr. Crowley, this is Mr. Timothy Ennis. Go ahead, dear.
Well, Timothy, I'm at your service. What have you got there?
I got two trains for Christmas. My mom bought me one train and my friend bought me this one. So please, can I have my money back?
Well, Timothy, this is a little unusual.
Got broken in the elevator, but I didn't do it, honest.
I see. So you got two trains for Christmas? Hmm?
I only got this one train. Steve got it for me. He's my friend. And he hasn't got any money.
No. Timothy, easy. Here, it'll be all right, you see. Now, come on, Timothy. Suppose you tell me everything that happened right from the beginning.
Well, see, it all started with my mother.
Yes, officer, he's been missing for almost 2 hours.
Where is he? Where could he be? He's never done anything like this before.
We've covered the entire neighborhood. Has he run away before?
He hasn't run away. Why would he run away?
No. Yes, he's wearing a yellow and blue ski jacket with a red hood, green corduroy
pants. They asked you that already. It's dark out.
No, we haven't checked them. Yes, officer, he's 6 years old.
Perfectly fine, Mrs. Ennis. Don't be too hard on him. Timothy, you're a difficult young man to resist, and I, for one, am awfully glad that I didn't. Good night, Timmy. Good night.
Thank you so much.
Good night, Mr. Crowley.
Mr.
Let's go home.
You went to Crowley's? Why?
I took my train back.
Your train? Oh, Tim.
Timmy returned his train.
Why?
It just cost too much. Steve doesn't have a job, so could you give him the money, Mom? Now, maybe he won't have enough to eat even. He needs it.
You are growing up on me so fast. Well, I suppose I should, don't you think?
Well, yes. Tim went to such lengths.
Will you go with me?
No time like the present. I'll get the car.
I'll call Mrs. Martin for you, okay? See if she can come downstairs and look after you till I get back.
And Mom? Lost it and didn't take the tray back because I didn't like it. Tell him that I'll never forget him either.
I will, sweetie. I'm so proud of you. Promise me you'll never go away like that again, okay?
Okay.
Promise?
Promise.
Where he lives?
Yeah, third floor. According to the mailbox.
Well, let's give him the money so we can get back to Tim.
Paul, will you give it to him? I'll wait here.
In the case of Jody Ennis versus Paul Davis, I offer certain facts in evidence.
Paul.
The party of the first part, Jody Ennis, Although known and loved by the party of the second part, Paul Davis, for 2 long years, did artfully and skillfully avoid the idea of marriage between them. However, upon the entrance of a stranger into her life some 3 days ago, said Jodi Ennis did suddenly and immediately consent to this marriage.
There was no connection between meeting Steve
and... Since the stranger entered her life, Jodi Ennis, normally calm, stable, and frank, becomes nervous, quick-tempered, and evasive.
I don't think I like this.
I don't like it either, Jodi. I can't pretend not to see what I see. You won't go up there because you don't have the courage to face him. To face it.
There is no it.
I was in the same room with the two of you yesterday, Jodi. Believe me, there is an it. Just how strong an it, I didn't know until tonight. You're in love with him.
I see. You've got it all worked out.
Well, it's my business to work things out. I mean, I know that if we went ahead and got married, you'd be thoughtful and considerate, and we'd have a very nice life together.
That's what I was hoping for.
But after I saw the way you looked at Steve, and knowing you'll never look at me like that, I'd always feel cheated. And a little sad.
You are such a wonderful man. You deserve someone who'll...
Love me? I agree. It's been a big week for both of us.
An awfully little train to have such a big effect on a person's life.
Anything can change a life that's ready to be changed. Mine was just changed by somebody not wanting to get out of a car.
It's been a long time.
No time's wasted to make two people friends. Better give him his money. I'll wait 5 minutes. If you don't find more interesting company, we still have a dinner date.
Jodi.
Come on up.
Come in.
No, thank you.
Hope you don't mind the smell of garlic.
No, I love garlic. Fabulous.
Thank you.
Really? Do it all yourself?
Yeah.
What a beautiful chair. So you're all packed.
Almost. Jodi, what are you doing here?
I have a check for you.
Jodi, I don't want your money.
It's from Tim. He returned his train. All by himself.
He was crazy about that train.
He thought you needed the money. He told me to tell you that he'd never forget you.
Well, I'll never forget him either.
Well...
Jodi, I'm sorry about yesterday.
No, there's no need.
No, it was a stupid thing for me to do. You were right to send me off. I should probably thank you.
No, don't thank me. In fact, I was going to apologize to you today.
You know, it's probably for the best.
Probably. Well, I'm gonna go. Paul's waiting for me.
Yeah. You two set a date yet?
We're not getting married. I guess you were right. I'm still not ready to share. I just need some time.
Time runs out, Jody. You know that better than any of us. Sometimes you just need to take a chance.
I can't do this right now.
Goodbye, Jody. I wish you all the best.
Want some more popcorn, Mom?
No, thanks, honey.
Come on, Mom. New Year's Eve. We're supposed to be having fun.
I'm sorry, sweetie. I was just thinking.
About what?
Things.
What kind of things?
Oh, the last year. Next year. That's kind of what you do on New Year's Eve. Oh, come on, we're supposed to be having a party. Let's have a party.
Oh, come on, Mom. It's not midnight yet.
It will be soon. Oh, what do you think? You gotta gear up for it. Yeah, is that pretty funny? Let's see you wear it. Whoa, Mr. Ennis, you look pretty good. What do you say we open the sparkling cider?
And let's call Steve.
Steve? You haven't mentioned him in days.
I think about him, though.
Me too.
Let's invite him to our party.
Well, sweetheart, we can't do that. Steve's leaving tonight. You know that. Even if he weren't, I think he's still kind of angry with me.
He still likes you, Mom.
Oh, yeah? How do you know that?
I've been angry with you sometimes, and I still like you.
Well, that's a good thing, because you're my best beau.
Well, I am probably moving somewhere else.
Move? Where?
Virginia, probably.
Virginia?
Of course, I will write to you and come visit you sometimes.
Oh, well, that's a good thing. I would like that.
But not a lot, because I'm probably getting married pretty soon.
Married?
Then you'll be all alone.
Well, it seems like you got your life pretty well planned out there, Mr. Ennis. You know, sometimes we plan and we plan and things just don't work out the way we think they're going to. Sometimes we just have to take a chance. Mr. Ennis, we've got a lot to do. Come on.
Thank you. Thank you.